Good morning. My name is M. Narasimha Rao, lecturer in physics. If you like my video lesson, please subscribe to my channel, Sai Dinesh NM. Today, I am discussing the relation between the object velocity, image velocity in the case of a spherical mirror. It may be concave mirror or it may be convex mirror. Now please listen here. Now this is the concave mirror. This is the pole of the mirror. It is the center of curvature of the spherical mirror. A straight line passing through the center of curvature and pole of the mirror, we are calling as the principal axis. Now, this is the point-sized object, small-sized object. Now, when the object is moving with a certain velocity towards the spherical mirror, with what velocity image is moving? Whether the image is moving double the velocity or whether the image is moving with the same velocity or three times the velocity. What is the relation between the object velocity and image velocity in the case of a spherical mirror? Here, in this, there are two cases I am discussing. If the point object is moving along the principal axis of a spherical mirror, case 1. Now, case 1. If the object is moving along the principal axis of a spherical mirror. This I will discuss now. Now please listen. Now this is the concave mirror. It is the concave mirror. Now this is the principal axis. It is the principal axis. This is the pole of the mirror. This is the principal focus. It is the center of curvature. It is the center of curvature. Now it is the point-sized object. Now this is the point-sized object. Now this object is moving along the principal axis. Velocity of the object I am representing with vivo. Now, here it is a point-sized object. This object is moving along the principal axis of a spherical mirror. Now, V naught represents the velocity of the object along the principal axis or parallel to the principal axis. Now this is the image. Image is moving away from the mirror. This is the velocity of the image. Now what is the relation between these two? I will discuss now. This is the object. The distance between the pole and the object we are calling as the object distance. It is represented by the letter small u. Small u represents the object distance. Now this is the image. The distance between the image and the pole we are calling as image distance. It is represented by small v. Now the distance between the pole and the principal focus we are calling as the focal length. It is represented by the letter small f. Suppose the focal length of this concave mirror is 20 cm. Whether the object is moving towards or away from the spherical mirror, focal length remains constant. We have taken focal length of this spherical mirror 20 cm. When the object is moving towards the mirror, when the object is moving away from the mirror, focal length of the spherical mirror is constant. You remember, focal length is constant. Focal length of the spherical mirror, it is a constant. Suppose its focal length 20 cm. It is a constant whether the image is moving or whether the object is moving. Now focal length is constant. Now please listen. Here the point size of the object is moving along the principal axis. Object is moving parallel to the principal axis. We know the mirror formula. Here we are discussing about the spherical mirror. We are having the mirror formula. According to mirror formula. Nana, please tell me what is a mirror formula. 1 by V plus 1 by U, that is equals to 1 by F. Here U represents the object distance. U represents the object distance from concave mirror or a spherical mirror. Spherical mirror or pole from the pole of the spherical mirror. V represents the image distance from the spherical mirror. F represents the focal length of the spherical mirror. Differentiating on both sides with respect to time. Differentiating on both sides. With respect to time. Here. Now, d by dt of 1 by small v plus d by dt of 1 by small u, that is equals to d by dt of 1 by small f. V is the distance, u is the distance, F is the distance. We know one formula in mathematics. D by dx of 1 by x. The formula is minus 1 by x square. D by dx of 1 by x. The answer is minus 1 by x square. Similarly, d by dt of 1 by v, it is nothing but 1 by minus 1 by v square dv by dt. D by dx of 1 by x is equal to minus 1 by x square. And plus d by dt of 1 by u. D by dt of 1 by u. D by dx of 1 by x is equal to minus 1 by x square. D by dt of 1 by u, it is nothing but minus 1 by u square du by dt. That is equal to F represents a focal length. Suppose you take focal length 20 cm. 20 cm is constant. Now, d by dt of constant. D by dt of constant, that is equals to 0. D by dt of constant. Constant is equal to 0. Focal length is constant. D by dt of constant. D by dt of constant is equals to 0. D by dt of constant is equals to 0. Here, now please listen. Minus 1 by v square into dv by dt plus into minus minus plus into minus minus 1 by u square du by dt, that is equal to 0. That is equals to 0. Now please listen here. Now this is the minus term. Now this is the minus term comes to this side. This minus term becomes a plus. Minus 1 by v square dv by dt is equals to. It is a minus term comes to this side. Plus comes to this side. Plus 1 by u square du by dt. Du by dt. Here. Now please listen here. V square goes to numerator. V square goes to numerator. V square goes to numerator. Dv by dt. Continuation I am writing. Continuation I am writing. Dv by dt. Dv by dt. That is equals to. Minus v square. Minus v square. By u square into du by dt. Now, in the case of a spherical mirror, for magnification, transverse magnification, or for magnification we are having one formula. Magnification small m is equals to minus v by u. Squaring on both sides, m square is equals to minus v by u whole square. M square is equal to minus square means minus becomes plus v square by u square. V square by u square means m square. V square by u square means m square. Dv by dt, that is equal to minus k minus. V square by u square. V square by u square means m square. V square by u square means m square. V square by u square means m square. Du by dt. Its meaning is what? dv by dt, v represents image distance. Image distance is changing with respect to time. dv by dt, v represents, v is not the final velocity. Some members are thinking u means initial velocity, v means final velocity. It's a distance, image distance by time. Distance by time means velocity. Now dv by dt, when v means velocity, velocity of the image with respect to the mirror, that is equals to dv by dt. Velocity of the object with respect to the mirror is equals to du by dt. Now please listen. V represents image distance. Image distance. V represents image distance by time velocity. Now this is the velocity of the image with respect to the mirror. With respect to the mirror. This is the velocity of the, it is the velocity of the image. Now it is the velocity of the image with respect to the mirror. That is equals to minus m square. U means object distance. U means object distance. A distance by time. Velocity. Now it is du by dt means change of object distance with respect to time. With respect to time. Du by dt. Du means object distance. Change in object distance by time. Object distance by time. Object velocity. Velocity of the object with respect to the mirror. With respect to the mirror. You may ask, why we are getting a negative symbol? Negative symbol indicates as the object is approaching towards the spherical mirror, image is moving away from the spherical mirror. As the object is approaching towards the spherical mirror, image is moving away from the mirror. It is moving right side, image is moving left side. Both are opposite in direction. For that reason, we got this symbol. We got this. Object is moving normal to the principal axis. For this concave spherical mirror, this is the principal axis. It is the point sized object. This point sized object is moving perpendicular to the principal axis. This point sized object is moving. This point sized object is moving perpendicular to the principal axis. Please listen here. The distance between the pole and the object we are calling as object distance. You consider this object distance is 10 centimeters. As the object is moving perpendicular to the principal axis, after some time this object is coming to here. At this point also, object distance is 10 centimeter only. Now, after some time, this object is coming to here. After 2 seconds, after 3 seconds, after 4 seconds, the object is coming to here. At this point also, object distance is 10 centimeter. As the object is moving perpendicular to principal axis, object distance remains constant. Object distance does not changes. As the object distance is not changing means image distance also not changing. Suppose you take image distance 15 centimeter here. Here also 15 centimeter. Here also 15 centimeter. As the object is moving perpendicular to the principal axis, object distance does not changes. Then image distance also does not changes. Object distance and image distance is constant. As the object, point sized object, as the object is moving perpendicular to principal axis, object distance is not changing, it's a constant. Image distance is constant. You know very well focal length is constant. You see here, object distance you take 10 centimeter. Here also 10 centimeter. Here also 10 centimeter. Object distance is constant. Then image distance also constant. Now please listen. We are having one formula for a transverse magnification. Simply we are calling as magnification. Transverse magnification, we are having one formula. Magnification is equals to height of the image by height of the object. That is equals to minus V by U. I represents the height of the image. O represents the height of the object. Image distance, it is object distance. Here no one is there, I am writing one. On cross multiplication, 1 into I, that is equals to M into O, M, O. I represents the height of the image. O represents the height of the object. As the object is moving with some velocity. Now this is the object velocity I am taking as V naught. Image velocity I am taking as VI. Now I means height of the image. O means height of the object. M represents the transverse magnification. Differentiating on both sides with respect to time. Differentiating on both sides with respect to time. This is now differentiating on both sides with respect to time. D by dt of I, that is equals to m is constant, m means transverse magnification, m into d by dt of height of the object. Di by dt. Now, I represents the height of the image. O represents the height of the object. As the object is moving, image also moving. Di by dt, we are calling as the velocity of the image with respect to the mirror. Di by dt, we are calling as velocity of the image with respect to the spherical mirror. That is equals to m into d by dt of O. O means height of the object. It is the position of the object is changing. Now it is nothing but the velocity of the object with respect to the mirror. When the object is moving with a velocity v naught, with a velocity of the object, it is the velocity of the image. Now this is the relation between the velocity of the image and velocity of the object. Now here vim means that is equals to di by dt, that is equals to velocity of image with respect to concave mirror or with respect to spherical mirror. Velocity of the object with respect to mirror is equals to dO by dt, velocity of object with respect to spherical mirror. Now these are the conditions. Thank you. If you like my video lesson, subscribe to my channel, Sai Dinesh NM.